Hello guys and welcome to this video. I'm Juxta from the Tech Cousins and you're watching War in the North. This is a third person hack and slash game based on the story of Lord of the Rings. And it is a side story to the main storyline, as you know from the books. And this is actually the story about how the general in the North was defeated. And let's just have a look at this cutscene and see our final boss.
Can it be? The same three lackeys who hid behind the elves at Fornost? You? You are the ones who have followed in my wake, upsetting my plans.
Yes, and we have thwarted you.
Sorry to interrupt, guys, but I seriously have something to ask you. If you ever wondered, how is it possible that all evil characters in all the history of evil characters, they all have that rusty hangover voice that you get from drinking or, yeah, drinking a lot of whiskey or brandy or beer or something like that. It is just like they're sitting in the mansion and just drinking and being drunk and just don't give a fuck about the minions being killed by the heroes. I actually think that's quite weird, and that is actually something that happens in pretty much all games that have this evil character. But yeah, and seriously, that teleport he just used, that ability would be so awesome to have. If imagine that you were laying in your bed and then you just use your teleport ability and then you were in your classroom. That would be just a snap. That would be so awesome. Oh yeah, and as you probably have noticed, I'm actually rolling on the floor for dodging his strike. And the reason for that is, you cannot block this guy. You have the blocking ability, but the more powerful NPCs are not blockable. So that's actually quite annoying, to be honest. And yeah, this is another mechanic. It is a fire hammer troll. And as you can see, there's some bugs. I can go straight through him while slashing. That's just weird. And also, I have to say, fire hammer troll. They took a troll, gave it a fire hammer, and called it a fire hammer troll. Seriously, the name-giving department of this game should really be fired. Seriously, hire me next time. I'll do it better. I'll be called it Big Fire Hammer Troll. Nah, that's not right. But nonetheless, he's dead now, and he's out of the way. And actually, I quite enjoy these small scenes. They always are funny to look at and quite good. And of course, the loot. Typical. Nothing. There is never anything for the ranger. You always have to purchase them at merchants, so that's pretty annoying. Another weird thing about this game is actually the smaller minions are in fact more difficult to defeat than the main boss. As you can see, they are dashing way more swiftly than... Yeah, alright, I went down there, but you get the point. Oh. Jesus, oh, that was bloody close. Jesus Christ. So, yeah, but the smaller minions are actually more difficult to defeat because of their more swiftly dash slashes and such. But as you can see there, they are blockable. So even though they are slashing a bit faster, they are actually interrupted quite easily. And I was also quite lucky that I wasn't hit by any of those blue balls. So that would be a nasty one if I were. So the boss is almost dead now. I just have to kill a bit of these minions, and then I'll go for Agendower. Yeah, that'll be the moment for now. And I'm going to shoot him down and dead. So thank you for watching this episode, guys. I'm going to cut it in two because this whole boss fight has two main fights. So I'll split it now, and I hope you enjoyed, and subscribe if you want to see the next part, and have a nice day. Thank you.